Come back here. I'm a savior of a sort.
Thanks for releasing me. I never dreamed.
That's it. That's it. Good girl.
Soul be so ignorant. I'm an answered prayer.
Yeah.
this much trouble.
Thank you.
Be as good to yourself as you've been to us. Haul anchor and heave to, men. It's the wide and glorious main for us.
Thank you. Every picture tells a story. Sometimes we don't like the ending. Sometimes we don't understand it.
Quite enough of that, I think. Enough preliminaries. Here's the performance you've been waiting for. Proves I am without prejudice and have a fine sense of humour. Sword and crown are worthless here. I invite everyone to dance. Labourers, lawyers, shirt and gown all make their little pranks. This life is full of random death and heaps of grievous shame. So few are soothed by accident. You want someone to blame. Fire, plague, and strange disease. Drowned, murdered, or if you please. A long fall down the basement stairs. None are expected. No one cares. I often must work very hard. Sweat running down my skin. After the dance, I then must rest. And the eating can begin. Time to eat. Death is the ultimate equalizer. All have the right to be eaten.
Get a knife, Princess. Don't push. All will be served.
So to speak.
Wicked thing. Feasting while Wonderland is destroyed.
I'm not the enemy you seek, Alice. I tried to hide this bit of Wonderland from that beast. Appeasement's never clean. We must all play our assigned roles. Are you a pawn or a queen? An idiot or a practiced fool? However this turns out, consider the prospect that you've been misled, Alice. Then ask, by whom?
No! Who set that bloody train in motion? Where has it come from?
It arrived when you arrived, and it's more horrible even than you could currently imagine. The death of a dream! Caterpillar may know how!
My mouth tastes like bile. Where's the brute that hit me, Nanny?
Nasty Pratt's out cold. Not dead, and more's the pity.
What did he want?
What they all want. Money he didn't earn. What were you thinking, butting into that mess? You could have been killed.
Nanny, my mind's in pieces. I still have terrible visions, and I need to know.
About the fire. Same as always. You need to move on, Alice. So do I.
Well, at least she's not spewing that asylum nonsense. My past is dead, I killed them, I should have saved them, I should have died. Her mind was in shambles. Radcliffe thought familiar faces would bring her round. After a year, he lost interest in their inheritance, greedy sod. Still, always asking his bizarre questions. Heavy dose of madness, I'd say, but honesty is never the best policy in this life. When she wasn't comatose, she gaped, eyes like pinwheels, drooled, occasionally squeaked. Never uttered a sensible sound. And like the child she was, she kept her secrets close.
run off some lurkers, common as cockroaches. And those poor tykes are food for perverts, like the blameless ants that wasps consume or spiders' feeble prey. You visited my room at Rutledge. What were you...
You recall that? Radcliffe paid me for a bit. A woman alone sometimes does what she doesn't particularly feel like doing, as you know.
Nurse Whitler said you'd fallen on hard times.
I'm no drunk like her. I'm hurting no one. Booking's not a bad life.
Except for the pimps. She also said you might have my rabbit. Please, Nanny, talk about
the damn fire. Never seems to help. Look, Alice, I can't give you what I don't have. Radcliffe wrote the inquest report. I'll take you to him. Besides, he's got your damn rabbit. You should remember that.
All right, but Mr. Radcliffe's useless.
Don't I know it?
He's crawling with rozzers since them bleeding murders.
Whose work was that?
You want to know that sort of thing? You've got to know where to listen.
Bit shy today, ain't you?
I ain't your dicky bird. Do your own fagging leg work.
To a girl's heart, don't you? And unless you open your purse a little wider, that's all you're gonna get.
Well, I'm sure we can work something out. You might get more if you stop talking.
Consider my lips sealed.
Oh no, dear. That wouldn't do at all.
You do have my rabbit.
Forgotten your manners?
And what else, I wonder? You abandoned it at Rutledge Asylum, my dear. We've been over this before. In a huff as usual, oozing with attitude and accusatory flummery, I've stolen her rabbit. Ridiculous pretext. She's here about the fire again. All the mad child wants to talk about. My report found her family dead by misadventure. She won't accept it. Goes on and on about her killing memories and her need to know the truth. The alleged truth is, the fire began in the library when the cat knocked over a lamp. The blaze trapped her parents and sister upstairs. Sister Lizzie never even unlocked her door. Died in her bed. The guilty cat always sets her off. She denies it. Makes no sense. It can't be, etc. Agreed. From the outset, Alice was my candidate for the pyromaniac. The girl had a fixation with fire. I once remarked that I thought she might have had a larger role in causing the tragedy. She suffered some sort of psychotic episode.
Did I rip his head off? I wanted to. What's left of my brain will explode. Is it mad to pray for better hallucinations? Perhaps I'm fated to expire right here.
Seeking refuge from the wicked world? Perhaps things only look like they've gone to hell.
You're not that good a liar, and I'm not that stupid. But something a bit less calamitous would have been welcome.
This unmitigated disaster is your doing, and it will get worse. Your train keeps a hellish schedule. Get moving. Time waits for no one. The change has begun.
The train is perfectly capable of terrifying me, Cat. You should find another job. Is there really so little hope?
There's even less. And if fear paralyzes you, we are lost.